coaches, we now need to make it a little bit more game related. So, when I say go, you and I are going to race in for the ball. Let's do it in slow motion. So I've said go, we are moving in. If we both do that, no one knows where the ball's going to go. But we want the ball for our team. So if you get there first, just go back to your line and your laces undone. Go. If you get there first, I want you to, if you can, put a barrier between you and your partner. All right? And now you can actually move the ball away from him. So if he moves around this way, we've got to keep the barrier. If I don't move, he's going to get it. So I have to keep the barrier between him and the ball. You've also got to watch for what around the edges. Yeah, because if you take the ball out in a game, the ball goes to the other team. So knowing where you are in the box is really important. Ready? Get the ball. You are not trying to beat them. You are not trying to nutmeg them. You are practicing keeping the ball for your team and hiding it from your opponent.
Red ball.
Go.
Watch it off.
What you're going to see, players reviewing it, trying to nutmeg, and really being quite fast and loose with possession. So we've got to change their psyche. We want the ball for our team. And when we play the matches, there are going to be times when all you've got to do is just hide the ball for a little bit longer to change the situation that you're in. Here's the next one. Coaches, who's triggered every activity at the moment?
You.
Me. In a game, I want the players to react to the movement of their opponent. So I'm now on strike for a bit. So I'm not going to say go. When either of you is ready, you can make a run in for the ball. All right, and your opponent's got to react. Yes, Freddie, if you get there first, you go for it. Yeah, he's got it. You've got to react. And you get players of this young age just staring and saying, what's happening here? We want them to say, he's moving, I've got to go. You can't get it unless you incorporate it into your training. All right, so it's some from me, and it's to have a little bit of control, but once you can let the reins off, let them do it randomly and one of them initiates it rather than me all the time. You decide when to go, but there's a different challenge now. Instead of hiding it, if I get to it first and Adam puts me under pressure, I can only be successful by manoeuvring the ball and placing it on this line here. If Adam gets it, he's got to hide it from me and try to place it on that line there. So this is tricky, but have a go. Ball in the middle, and then we're going to do a match. Yeah, he's gone. You've got to react. Oh, love it. So again, I'm moving through these quite quickly, all right? You might do 10, 15 minutes on just one of them, and then introduce them. I'm trying to give you some ideas. I've had the ball in the middle. You can place the ball on the edge of the box, so that when players are running towards it, it's a different kind of barrier. Because if the ball's over there and I'm right-footed and I control it like that and the defender's coming from there, I'm actually revealing the ball straight away and I've got no space here. So what you want the players recognising is if it's there and the defender's coming from there, I might take it on my left foot and hide it initially until the next bit. So all of those refined decisions we can build in to the way just by putting the ball in a different place.